The weekend is on deck, and so is nighttime baseball from Petco Park in San Diego's Gaslamp District. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the San Francisco Giants and the San Diego Padres. San Diego have lost their last five games. They'll attempt to break that streak right after this. Blake Snell, the southpaw out of the state of Washington, will be the starter. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, in this day and age where we're used to seeing a lot of home runs and pitchers not going very deep in a game, how about this guy? ERA in the low ones. That's not an easy thing to do. He can strike people out, but he can also get them out via the ground ball, the fly ball. Judging by his stats this year, he is having a ridiculously good season up to this point.
First pitch. The windup and the 0-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He's got it. Throw on to first in time, one away. One out, base is empty. And in to hit next, it'll be Austin Slater. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. There's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside. Guys, the swinging Friars as they take the field here tonight. They come into this one in need of some kind of spark to turn them around as they find themselves in the midst of a five-game slide.
Yeah, I get it, Matty. The team's on a moderate losing streak right now. Can't be happy with the way they've played, but they have to find a way to relax a little bit. Everybody goes through these little stretches, these little valleys throughout the course of a long season. This team should right itself, and it needs to start today.
In for strike two.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. A swing and a ground ball to third. And that's the second out. Base is empty, two away, and now stepping in is Mike Yastrzemski. First delivery to him.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
0-1, here's the pitch. Fouled away. Top of the first, just underway at Petco Park. Frozen for strike three, and that retires the side. Giants are down 1-2-3. Giants 0, Padres coming up. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Kevin Gausman, the native of Colorado, gets the start on the mound. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Now into the box, Tommy Pham. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
For the Padres, the left fielder, Tommy Pham.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. 0-1 the count. Now here's the pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder giving chase, and no one will track it down. Drill down the line. A dive, and he knocks it down. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what undoubtedly will be scored as an infield single.
Batting second. The second baseman.
Jake. And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Guys, you take a look at the Giants as they begin play here tonight. They come in off another victory last time out, and now they're winners of eight of their last nine ball games.
Yeah, Matty, this is going to be an interesting watch for me. I can only think back to when you're facing an ace. The team's playing well, you're confident. You go to the ballpark and you want to set the tone. Everybody's in the hitters' meetings trying to formulate a game plan to combat what this guy's been able to do throughout the course of the season so far. This should be an interesting game of cat and mouse today.
Now a ground ball for Longoria. This could be two. Solano for one to Belt for the twin killing.
Batting third. Not shortstop.
So here is Fernando Tatis Jr., and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. He's set. Here it comes. And that fastball's taken, but catches the outer third.
Hey, they say solos won't kill us, but I gotta believe this guy's looking to do exactly that.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
Yeah, if he's gonna pound the zone with this stuff all game, the offense better step up. Somebody's gonna have to pull.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Nothing in the San Diego first. We'll go to the second downtown. Scoreless. Second inning set to go, and standing in the outfielder, Alex Dickerson.
The left fielder, Alex Dickerson.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Ball.
The 1-0. Popped him up. Nola waits on it. One away.
Batting fifth, the catcher, number two, Kurt Casale.
Digging in next, Kurt Casale. Now the first pitch. Yeah. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Hey, this offense better be prepared to pull a trigger. This starter is known to be aggressive and come right after you.
He comes up empty that time as he's underneath it, 0-2.
Every time you go out there to start a game on the mound, you hope to settle in quickly and get into a groove, and he's definitely done that so far in the early going. Looks like he could go pretty deep into this one.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Lifted down the line and left. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. That's two down, no one on base. And that brings up Evan Longoria. First offering on its way.
Well located fastball right there. If he can continue to do that, he'll pitch deep into this one.
Two balls and a strike to Longoria. No score here as we play inning number two. Strike taken as the curveball drops into the bottom part of the zone.
Well, he snapped that breaking ball off really nice. He'll do well to keep putting it there.
Hit hard on the ground to second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Giants down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring in Manny Machado.
For the Padres, the third baseman, Manny Machado.
Yeah. wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. High and deep down the left field line. Comes set with the 0-1. Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one.
If he doesn't shorten his swing up right there, there's no chance he keeps his bat back.
The 1-1. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. And it's fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Sliced hard on the ground. Throw just in time as they get him by an eyelash.
Got it, good. The first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
So one down, no one aboard. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Now here's the pitch. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one. A ball and a strike to the Padres first baseman.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
The 1-1 home. Hard on the ground towards short. Crawford fields it cleanly. And there are two away now.
That is good.
Next up, Will Myers. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Set and the pitch. Didn't quite catch the zone there. Ball one. Bottom of the second here with no score.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Oh, textbook slider there, and he's back at even, 2-2.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
3-2 pitch. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three. Clearly enjoying their time here at the ballpark, as are we. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Back alongside Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, as it'll be Brandon Belt getting ready to lead things off here. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a liner. Grisham is under it to make the catch for out number one. So with one away now, let's quickly give you a look at the standings in the National League West entering play today as you see where these two teams sit in relation to one another. Now at the plate is Brandon Crawford. First pitch on its way.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Popped him up. Tatis over to his left. And he makes the catch for the second out. So next to hit is Kevin Gausman. This guy is still looking at a zero in the hit column. Here's the first pitch to him. Down the first baseline. Fielded cleanly by Hosmer. Over to first, and that retires the side. Giants are down on four pitches. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Bottom of the third now, and now it'll be the catcher, Austin Nola.
The catcher, Austin Nola.
First delivery to him. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. With that, the inning opens with the Padres getting their leadoff man on base.
Dan, he took that right back at his face right there. Exactly what you're trying to do. Middle cut, though. Are you a little concerned?
Yeah, that's a case of a ball being right down the middle. As a pitcher, you want to work the corners and stay out of that middle part of the zone. And he paid for it right there with a solid base hit.
And the hit will be Trent Grisham. He swings and sends it in the air out to left center. Slater is right there, one down. Now it'll be Blake Snell. He could be bunting here in order to stay out of the double play. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
What a well-executed fastball right there. Down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
One ball, one strike, the count. The 1-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Slater's under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. So a runner at first with two away. And up next, it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham. As a look, now the pitch. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one. Hit in the air down the right field line. A bouncer to the left side. Up with it is Longoria. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Padres leave one. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Donovan Solano. Back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Hard hit towards center. He'll put it away without much trouble, and the leadoff man is retired here in the fourth.
Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
So that brings up the outfielder, Austin Slater. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
Hey, you want to talk about being in the zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher. Just go ahead and challenge him.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Into the windup and the pitch. He loses him on ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Mike Yastrzemski digging in at the plate. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Nope, that's the ball.
Giants are still searching for their first hit of the ballgame. Now a double play ball here as this is on the ground to third. On to Hosmer, a double play, and that ends the inning. They make it look easy, don't they? Around the horn for the double play to end the inning. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Now to bat, Jake Cronenworth. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
There is Crawford. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Next, here is Fernando Tatis Jr. looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, kind of shocked. He got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
No balls and a strike to count. Fouled off.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at-bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
Hit back up the middle. And that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
Well, you know what? Good hitters are good hitters for a reason, D-Row. And to be able to hang in there on an 0-2 pitch and still be able to get a base hit, this guy's about as good as it gets.
Yeah, I'm blown away by this guy, Dan. You wouldn't know if you showed up. You wouldn't know if it's 2-0, 3-1, 0-2. Counts do not matter. This guy trusts in his craft.
And in steps Manny Machado. Popped up. Crawford is there. Two down. Into the box, Eric Hosmer. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. From the stretch, runners on the move for second. Pitch outside, the throw, not in time as he steals second. Certainly a very close play at second on that bag, so let's analyze it with Showtrack. We all know he's got plus speed on his side, and you really see it represented in the top speed. That really made the difference on that one. The 1-0. Pulled toward right center field. Right fielder giving chase. He won't have a play, and this should finally get him on the board. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Hey, this team's been in a pretty bad funk, D-Row. They've had a difficult time scoring and winning any game, so to strike early, that RBI single right there is awfully big.
Yeah, and hopefully the pitcher's able to breathe a sigh of relief, Dan, like you say all the time. Give me some early runs and let me relax and attack the zone.
I've always said, D-Row, you score me 6 runs, I'm going to win a lot of games.
Will Myers is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one. Mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown a first pitch strike to.
1-1 the count now. Down the third baseline. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So a run on 2 hits, no errors, and a man left. New inning set to get underway, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Alex Dickerson. Here's the first pitch to him. Lifted the other way down the left field line. The windup and the 0-1. Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1 and 2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
That's just quality pitching right there for that strikeout. Some guys are real good low ball hitters, but more often than not, keeping the ball down is going to lead to a lot of success on the mound.
Standing in now, Kurt Casale, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And that's right there, and we're even at 1. Swing and a liner, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. 2 down. So 2 away now for the slugger, Evan Longoria. First pitch on its way. No runs, no hits, and no errors on the giant ledger to this point. Downstairs, 2 balls and no strikes. And he fouls this one off. The 2-1 home. Scorched to third. Taken in by Machado. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. Giants are down 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Bring up Austin Nola. He'll step in to start things out here against Kevin Gausman. First pitch coming. Here it is. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-1 home. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. So a ringing single here to center field makes it 2 hits for him on the night. And you can see on the graphic his total for the year places him 3rd best on the San Diego roster. Stepping in next, Trent Grisham flew out in his only at-bat so far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. A double play ball to second. 4-6-3, but it's not in time, and they'll just get the 1. So now here is Blake Snell, flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. As a look, now the pitch. Runner goes. Pitch outside, the throw, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Hey, it's almost impossible to throw a base runner out that gets a lead that big, and plus this catcher's not known for having a cannon of an arm.
Here's the 1-1 delivery. Bunt still on here with one away as he puts this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Well, when you're trying to move a guy up to third with a bunt, that's exactly how you want to do it. Make the third baseman field the ball. That way his only play is to first. That was very well executed.
At the plate, Tommy Pham. He grounds it sharply to third. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. One left for San Diego, but they lead it 1-0. So in now for San Francisco, Brandon Belt hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
And that was one of the hardest hit balls they've had all game, Matty. It's been a pretty feeble effort by his teammates on the offensive side.
One ball, no strikes, the count. The 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike. There's a good breaking ball down on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
You could tell this guy's got great feel for all his stuff right now. To break out that nasty hammer right there, this guy's on point.
Fouled away.
Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
Here's another 1-2. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a 1-2 pitch, but you could see that he wasn't laying down without a fight. He really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
Here's the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there at strike one. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. That's the first hit in this one for the Giants.
He doubled up on that one, Danny. Back-to-back changeups. Nice job by the batter right there, staying on that pitch.
That's one of the things that this pitcher will do, though, Mark. His changeup is so good, he's not afraid to throw it back-to-back pitches.
In now, Kevin Gausman. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there.
Well, he took a risk with the decision to throw to second instead of taking the sure out at first. Not sure if someone was yelling for him to go to second, but we know now it was the wrong call.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Donovan Solano trying here to plate the tying run from second. He's set. Here it comes. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. A ball and a strike to the Giants' leadoff man. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Ready now. Two-strike pitch on its way. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Fly ball out toward left center field. Grisham calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out. So next to bat will be Austin Slater. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. Skied into straightaway right. Myers is under it. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. Giants leave a couple. They still trail 1-0. now for San Diego, Jake Cronenworth. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Not too many guys taking the mound today with this good a split. Look at the downward action on that thing. It's falling off the table.
Belt has it, and he'll step on first himself for the out. So with one away now, let's quickly give you a look at the standings in the National League West entering play today as you see where these two teams sit in relation to one another. And stepping in, Fernando Tatis Jr. singled in his last at-bat. Here's the first pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
Hey, guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock of the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking, we really avoided a worse fate. Here's Manny Machado now. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Tatis, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Him up. Belt moving to his left. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop out. Well executed pitch there.
First baseman Eric Hosmer is in as he'll take a look at ball one. Now the 1-0, and they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. One run, six hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Ball hit on the ground here for the first baseman Belt, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Padres leave one. They lead it 1-0. Stepping up is Mike Yastrzemski. And, guys, seventh inning already? Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulted in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Ooh, and he finds his spot there, 1-1.
Nice adjustment out on the mound. Overthrew the first one a little bit, but got on top and let that ball rip right out in front of him.
Hit down the third baseline. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. And he'll get in at second base as the tying run's aboard with a leadoff double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they can get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
And that'll bring up the big bat of Alex Dickerson. Pitch rides in on him here as this is popped weakly toward the left side of the infield. Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first out.
I'm sure his eyes lit up when he saw that curveball hanging in the zone. But maybe he tried to do too much with it because basically he hit it straight up. No doubt he wants that pitch back. And the pitcher, he just dodged a bullet.
Into the box, Kurt Casale. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Now the 1-0. And here's a ball hit in the air. After it is Myers. And no one will get this one.
I know that fastball registered at about 92-93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
This one's down to third. Machado has it, and there's out number two. So two away now in the San Francisco seventh. And standing in here, the veteran third baseman, Evan Longoria. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Fouled off. But right there is the second baseman, and that will retire the side. One left for San Francisco. They're down 1-0. Last half of the seventh here, and coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Will Myers.
The right fielder, Will Myers.
He's set, and the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Yastrzemski's got it, and there's one gone.
Now got it.
Next to the plate for the Padres, Austin Nola. Two base hits, both singles to this point. First pitch on its way. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Slater's under it. Two gone. Two outs now in the San Diego seventh, and that brings up Trent Grisham. Now the first pitch.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Lifted the other way to left center. Slater is there, and it's a very quick inning as the side is retired. Takes just four pitches to retire the Padres, but they're up 1-0. Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
First baseman, number 9, Brandon Belt.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
Nope, outside.
Now the 1-0. Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8.
Now that
Brandon Crawford digging in next. A hit and 2 tries for him so far. Here's the first pitch to him.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because his first pitch strike ratio is still under 60%.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And this is fouled at the plate. Another 1-2 delivery. Hit in the air to center field. Grisham is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Mauricio Dubon will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 1, Mauricio Dubon.
Now the first pitch. Swing and a liner. Well, the shortstop's got him played perfectly as he takes this in for the third out. Giants down in order. It remains 1-0. Trust me when I tell you no exceptions to the rule. Bringing blessings when I'm moved. Jose Alvarez is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Jorge Mateo is going to grab a bat here as he looks to try to set the table in the bottom of the eighth as they look for some insurance. First pitch of the AB now. Liner towards second. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out. The Giants are into their bullpen now as there are the final numbers for their starter. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
One of the big keys to having a good pitching performance is not being afraid to throw the ball into the strike zone. And this guy certainly wasn't in this one. Didn't allow a walk all game long.
To the plate now, Tommy Pham. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Obvious pitch recognition right there. 0-0 changeups usually get guys out in front, but he was able to stay back, recognize it, and drive it for a base hit.
At the plate now, Jake Cronenworth. Pitch out, nothing doing. Now the 1-0. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? One there on the belt, but it won't be in time as they just settle for one.
Up next.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and up steps the big bat of Fernando Tatis Jr. From the belt, kicks and deals. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in a 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Grounded down the third baseline. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Hey now. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. We've played eight full. It's the Padres 1 and the Giants nothing. Keone Kella comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Keone Kella.
All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Donovan Solano.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
The 0-1 delivery and a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. To short. Right to him. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. So his day over now as you get a look at the pitching line for the San Diego starter. He was great all night long.
Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
Austin Slater comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. 0 for 2 for him to this point. great job of changing speeds there. It's 0-2. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
Mike Yastrzemski.
Giants down to their final out now. And now stepping in is Mike Yastrzemski. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. The 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike.
His heater's got some late ride through the zone. A lot of late swings right now. You're only going to get to that pitch if you get the front foot down early.
Reined in. Throw to first here will be in time to record the final out, and the Padres have ended their five-game losing streak as the ball game is over. And that one run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. San Diego took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Blake Snell earns his first win of the season, allowing only a pair of hits in eight full innings pitched. Kevin Gausman is settled with a loss after giving up only one earned. Keone Kella hammers down the save, his 12th of the season. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com. Background track, they want me back. I'm gonna have to green it all like Bill White Wall in the field line. Worry about talking, just my time. The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious San Diego Padres, one run, seven hits, no errors. They left five men on base. For the Giants, no runs on only two hits, no errors. They left four men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 20 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight.